I want to thank you for joining us today. It is a very exciting day for all of us, and especially for our new volunteers. We want to express our deep appreciation for the support and contributions that many of you, our staff, our families, and our partners have made in preparing these trainees for their service, and that others of you will make over the next 2 years as they collaborate with you to do great work in your communities.
Didi Madroba, Inistrusion Shemokuyevdit, Estret Olaspis and Tsuria, Kasakutrebit Kitrani Ahai Mohani Servistris, Source of Messi Madroba Gadet Hadot, in Hyde Chenis and Tsuristris, Pamelit Bermat Pengama, Hanam Shomlevma, Oja Hedma,
In recognition of the bonds of peace and friendship between our countries, we would like to begin our ceremony today by welcoming to the stage a group of trainees who perform the Georgian and American national anthems.
Trans partner shows in Shrido Pisada Mego Grobis Nishlan, Sush 20 ceremony of Gausnet, Mohai Sedis, Tena de Mutavi, from Levit Shabus Fulebe, Sakatosa da Ameriki, Sakhansi Kokimis.
Thank you.
now. Please welcome Country Director of the Peace Corps, Mr. Jeffrey Gobea.
First of all, can I ask for another round of applause for both our professional singers and our semi-professional singers? I hope everyone can realize how difficult it is in a short period of time to learn a language and then learn to sing the national anthem and then be willing to stand in front of a group of this size and do it. So thank you for that extra bit of work on behalf of the training singers. Dear United States Ambassador to Georgia, Kelly Dignan, Deputy Minister of Education and Science, Tamar Maharashvili, U.S. and Georgian government officials, supervisors, counterparts, and host family members, returned Peace Corps volunteers from Georgia and around the world, Peace Corps Georgia staff, volunteer, can I have one volunteer stand up quickly and wave? That's Susie, that's our one volunteer. Thank you, Susie. Trainees, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon and welcome to the swearing in ceremony of this 20th group of American Peace Corps volunteers to serve here in Georgia. As Renee Bulico noted, I am Jeffrey Gamea, and I really have the great and distinct privilege of serving as the Peace Corps Country Director here. The Peace Corps, if you've never heard it explained this way, is an international network of volunteers, community members, host country partners, and staff, each of whom finds themselves on a unique path of service that is defined by the enduring desire to learn beside of and grow along with people of the world. The Peace Corps' approach to its work is grounded in mutual respect and dedication to collaboration that seeks to make change at the local level as requested and desired by the people most directly impacted by our work. Wherever volunteers serve, they come at the invitation of the host government, and I'd like once again to thank Deputy Minister Maharashvili for the gracious invitation that the government of Georgia has continued to extend to the Peace Corps over these past 22 years. We look forward to finalizing and signing our next memorandum of understanding, our fifth, between your ministry and our agency later this year. Your ministry, its staff, principals, and teachers have all been wonderful partners, and we look forward to continuing to support your ministry's efforts and goals to continue to improve education in this amazing country. Peace Corps' approach to its work is not centered on our volunteers. It is centered on the one-on-one partnerships that volunteers and their counterparts form that generate progress, create learning, understanding, and value for those who encounter and benefit from these partnerships. Indeed, partnership and actual partners, including at least one American, represented on stage here, and actual partners, including at least one Georgian, are embedded within Georgian schools, organizations, and communities, and this lies at the center of our model of engagement. At times, these nuclei of peace and understanding can be seen in ways fairly similar to the image on our 20th anniversary poster. In my 30 years of experience with Peace Corps, I have multiple memories of pulling into schoolyards or communities or organizational parking lots and seeing scenes very similar to this one, where you have a volunteer and a counterpart surrounded by children or youth or women's leaders or people with disabilities, and they show this energy of people
seeing the passion that the volunteers and their counterparts have. Nevertheless, our partnerships aren't really about this energy. The energy is merely a byproduct of the hard work that the volunteers and partners devote in bridging cultural divides to seek common understanding, or when they realize common understanding can't be found, to find respect for differences. In one of the more famous speeches by Peace Corps' founder, then President John F. Kennedy, he famously noted that we do these things not because they are easy, but because they are hard. For the historians in the room, drunk. You'll know that President Kennedy was not referring to the Peace Corps in this case. He was referring to the United States taking a shot at the moon. But in some ways, mustering sufficient humility, understanding, and grace to meet another person where they are across language barriers and cultural barriers in pursuit of a new idea for a project or a new approach to teaching English sometimes may seem as hard as reaching the moon. And yet, it's something that volunteers and partners have succeeded in doing around the world since 1961 and here in Georgia since 2001. I think these trainees here on the stage and the supervisors and partners and homestay families in advance for the effort, trust, and grace you will expend in becoming better teachers together and in improving your ability to better serve youth and organizations and your organizational beneficiaries together. In recognizing that your work will often feel very difficult, I also recognize that you will grow and improve as a result of your efforts. For the trainees here on stage, I hope you can appreciate how much you've already grown since you got here. In so many ways, though, you are only just beginning. When I speak to volunteer groups like Helping Hand here in Georgia, I often speak of how volunteering has a magical quality to it. And the magic is this: volunteers, and in using this term, I mean both the Peace Corps volunteers and the partners they work with, get more from volunteering than they put into it. It always happens. They always get more. Further, if they give more to the effort, they only get more out of it. So the more you put into it, the more you'll get out of it. And that goes for all the people in this broad network of Peace Corps and Peace Corps volunteers around the world. Before I close, I'd like to recognize several important and noteworthy groups of people in this room. May I first ask the Peace Corps training staff to rise? Peace Corps training staff, please. As I noted to all of you on the first day of your training of trainers, when volunteers complete their service, and this has been true in all the Peace Corps countries I've been in, when they complete their service and they sit in my office with me to talk about what has been meaningful, they will invariably talk about all of you. 2 years later, they will still remember their language trainers. And I thank you for everything that you put into making sure that this group is going to do the same. And I look forward to their stories 2 years from now. Thank you very much. May I ask the training and permanent homestay families to stand? So if you are a homestay family representative, can you please stand? Volunteering to be host. Even 28 years after my own volunteer service ended, I still think of myself as having a mother in the United States and a mother in a small village in Tennessee. I know that the people here on the stage will feel similarly about you, and I thank the training homestay families for all that you did to help prepare these volunteers, and I thank you for the warm welcome and familial love the new families will show to these volunteers as well. So thank you very much, homestay. May I ask the volunteer counterparts and supervisors to stand? Counterparts and supervisors. There we go. Really, really warm. think I said this to most of you, or well, to all of you on Saturday as well, but in so many ways,
you are the Georgian volunteers that ensure that Peace Corps benefits your students, your beneficiaries, and your communities. You're the second half of this picture. And Peace Corps only works with you because you make the partnerships that create the energy and create the benefits happen. So thank you in advance for your time, your efforts, your patience, and your desire to learn alongside your volunteers. Most of these partners and organizations have hosted volunteers before, and they know the reality of this. And I thank you for sticking with us through the pandemic, sticking with us, knowing that 4 years ago we first started talking with you about taking a volunteer. And we're so happy that in your case, that volunteer is coming back with you today. So thank you for your patience and your time. Next, may I ask all of the returned Peace Corps volunteers in the room to stand. All of the returned Peace Corps volunteers. I'm one. Peace Corps often states that our commitment to promoting world peace and friendship lasts a lifetime. Thanks to all of you for the work that you currently do and for all the creative ways you continue to find to infuse your work with a little bit of Peace Corps magic, understanding, humility, patience, and awareness. G20's here on stage. The people standing now represent a legacy burnished by almost 250,000 Americans who have pledged to serve, like you just, or you will soon, to serve the Peace Corps mission in the way that you will begin to do in a few more moments. They continue to give back to the world in countless ways, and have forged paths in ways that you may choose to emulate. Thank you all for your service as volunteers and for your continued service as our PCBs. And for the Georgian RPCBs, thank you for your past commitment to service, for your love of Georgia and Georgians that clearly grows daily, and for your willingness to share what makes you uniquely American and to share back to friends and family in the U.S. what you uniquely love about Georgia. To all of you, you have shown the same dedication through your pre-service training, including your dedication to learn and improve your skills, your language, and your understanding in ways that will allow you to be of even greater service to the schools, organizations, and communities to which you have been assigned. On behalf of all of the Peace Corps Georgia staff, the people that I continue to believe are the most amazing colleagues in the world, it is my pleasure to recommend to the ambassador that she will administer the Pledge of Service to you and officially make you the 20th group of Peace Corps volunteers to begin their service in Georgia. Didi Madhava.
Salmon, Havadon Kelly Degner, Chess Mabel Bars, ამერიკის შეერთებული შტატების საგანგებო და სრულუფლებიანეთის საქართველოში მაქს პატივი მივესალმო მშვიდობის კორპუსის ხელმძღვანელს საქართველოში ჯეფრი თქვენი სიტყვა და თქვენი გამოსვლის შემდეგ ძალიან ძნელია აქ იქ სცენაზე და რაიმე თქვა და დაამატა.
Good afternoon, my friends. I would love to welcome Madam Ambassador of the United States to Georgia, Mr. Denman, to Peace Corps Director Jeffrey Coveyor. After your words, it's so difficult to add something else than standing here. So,
ძალიან ემოციური დღეა დღეს, მეგობრებო, რადგანაც დღევანდელი დღე ეძღვნება მეგობრობას. დღევანდელი დღე ეძღვნება სიყვარულს. და დღევანდელი დღე ეძღვნება ერთმანეთს გაუზიაროთ ჩვენი გამოცდილება და ვისწავლოთ ერთმანეთისგან.
It's a very emotional day today because this is dedicated to our friendship, to love and to sharing to each other and to learn from each other.
ჩემთვის პატივია ვუყურო იმ ქვეყნის წარმომადგენელს ქალბატონ დეგნას, რომელსაც უამრავი რამე აქვს ჩვენი ქვეყნისთვის გაკეთებული და არის ერთ-ერთი ყველაზე ძლიერი პარტნიორი ჩვენი ქვეყნისა სხვადასხვა სფეროში, მაგრამ განსაკუთრებით განათლების სფეროში.
And it's a big honor for me to be together with the ambassador Ms. Kelly Degnan, who has done enormous a lot of things for our country in many directions and especially for education.
ჩვენი ქვეყანავართ და ის ხალხი ვართ, რომელსაც გადაჭარბების გარეშე შეგვიძლია ვთქვა, რომ ყველაზე კარგად ვიცით მეგობრობის ფასს.
We are the country and we can say that without any exaggeration. We are the nation that knows the value of friendship the best.
ჩვენი ქვეყანავართ, სადაც UNESCO უსწორედ განიხილავს ჩვენი და თუნდაც ებრაელი ხალხის 26 საუკუნოვანი მეგობრობის ტრადიციას და შესაბამის სტატუსსაც მიანიჭებს, როგორც გამორჩეული ურთიერთობის და არამატერიალური კულტურული ძეგლის სეგმენტში.
And we are the country that UNESCO is considering the 26th century long friendship between Georgians and Jewish people and considers to grant a special status as extraordinary relationship and friendship between these nations.
Маша Садаме, ჩვენ ყველაზე გამორჩეულად გვესმის მეგობრობის ფასი და ის, რაზეც დღეს უნდა ვისაუბროთ, ჩვენთვის, ჩვენი ერისთვის არის უმნიშვნელოვანესი.
So it means that we do really recognize and understand the value and friendship and the topic that we are going to discuss today and talk today is so important.
უყურებ ამარა ჩვეულებრივ ახალგაზრდებს და მინდა ვუთხრა მათ უღმესი მადლობა იმისათვის, რომ ისინი არიან დღეს საქართველოში და მზადარიან თავისი გამოცდილება, თავისი განსაკუთრებული ხედვა, თავისი დამოკიდებულება, თავისი კულტურა შეიტანონ ჩვენ სკოლებში და შეიტანონ ჩვენ სოციუმში.
I look at this, I'm looking at this wonderful young people and I see that they are ready to bring their experience, their vision, their attitude and culture to our schools, to our institutions.
რა თქმა უნდა, ამაყივართ ამით, მაგრამ ასევე ვიცი და მეთანხმებით, მეგობრებო, რომ იმ პერიოდის შემდეგ, როდესაც იმ დატოვებენ საქართველოს, არაჩვეულებრივად მღერიან მადლობა ეხლა, მაგრამ უკეთესად იმღერებენ ქართულს, უკეთესად შეისწავლიან ქართულ ცეკვას, ქართულ ტრადიციებს და ძალიან შევთქვათ, დამდიდრებულები წავლენ საქართველოდან.
And I'm really proud to see this and I'm sure that when volunteers leave Georgia when this time comes, they will be better in singing, in dancing, in Georgian singing, they sing so well even now and they will leave this country even more enriched.
რამედიერება, როცა აქ ამ დარბაზში ვხედავ ჩვენ სკოლის წარმომადგენლებს, ხელმძღვანელებს, მასწავლებლებს, იმ ადამიანებს, რომლებზეც დგას მთლიანად ჩვენი სისტემა და ნებისმიერი ჩვენი რეფორმა ან გადაზმული ნაბიჯი, სწორედ ამ ადამიანებს მიაქვს სკოლამდე და მიაქვს ყველაზე მთავარ სამიზნემდე, ჩვენ მოსწავლეებს.
I'm so happy to see here representatives of our schools, teachers, principals. They are the people on whom is based our system and all the forms all the decisions are taken to schools and to our target group of students by them.
Da es ადამიანები დღეს ვინც აქ არის წარმოდგენილი სკოლები არ არის მხოლოდ თბილისის სკოლა ეს არის რეგიონები რაც ყველაზე მნიშვნელოვანია და მათი მზაობა და სურვილი ჩართული იყვნენ ამ არჩეულებრივ და ძალიან მნიშვნელოვან პროცესში კიდევ უფრო სხვა ხილის მადებს თემატურ ღონისძიებას
And it should be noted that these are not the schools only from Tbilisi. These are schools from different regions of Georgia and their readiness and their ability to be involved in this process is even more
ასევე უნიშნელოვანესია გამოხოთ და მივესალმო ოჯახებს, რომლებიც არიან გახსნილი და აქვთ უდიდესი მზაობა, რომ ჩართული იყვნენ ამ მნიშვნელოვან პროცესში. მადლობა თქვენ ამისთვის, ჩვენი სახელითაც მინდა მადლობა გითხრათ და მინდა აქვე ხაზი გავუსვათ და ვთქვათ თქვენ ემსახურებით საერო საქმეს.
I also would like to recognize and thank host families who are involved in this whole process and I would like to recognize their special role and say that you serve this very important cause for the nation.
Davos. Minda ugmesi madloba gadaukhado chwes trenerebs. Minda madloba gadaukhado im adamianebs zogadat vis uzrumlelobs tkhianat protsesis kharisks.
And finally I would like to thank our trainers for really
Jeffrey
thanked the ministry for being involved in this process, but on my behalf, I would like to thank you for providing this opportunity for us and for helping us.
უღმესი მადლობა თავისი გუნებით დახასიათით. ყველა აქტივობა, რომელიც მიემართება სასკოლო საზოგადოებას, არის განათლებისა და მეცნიერების სამინისტროსთვის უმნიშვნელოვანესი, თუმცა არსებობს აქტივობები, რომელიც არის განსაკუთრებული. ამიტომ ვისარგებლებ შემთხვევით და ვიტყვი, რომ დიახ, მშვიდობის კორპუსის საქმიანობა არის სრულიად განსაკუთრებული.
All the activities that are related to education and schools are so important. But there are some activities that are really special and extraordinary, and I can say that the work of this corps is really special and extraordinary too.
განათლებისა და მეცნიერების სამინისტროს სახელით მაქვს პატივი კიდევ ერთხელ დაგიდასტუროთ ჩვენი მზაობა, ასევე გამოხატოთ ჩვენი მადლიერება იმ საქმესთან დაკავშირებით, რომელსაც ქვია მშვიდობის კორპუსის საქმიანობა ჩვენს ქვეყანაში. Და კიდევ ერთხელ დავადასტურო, რომ ჩვენი სამინისტრო აქტიურად და მასშტაბურად იქნება ჩართული ამ პროცესში.
And on behalf of the Ministry of Education, I would like to once again reaffirm our readiness to cooperation and express our deep gratitude for the work that this corps is doing in Georgia.
ძალიან დიდი მადლობა. მეგობრობა ცვლის სამყაროს.
Thank you so much. Friendship changes the world.
For this important event, I just had a few words that I wanted to say as well. Thank you, dear Tamara. Thank you very much for being here and for all the wonderful support. Thank you to Jeffrey and our fabulous Peace Corps staff that has been working so hard toward this day for the past 2 years, really. We've been just so waiting for your arrival and for this moment. And of course, to the host families, to the schools who are going to support this program that has made just such an impact between the United States and Georgia. Last year, we celebrated 30 years of diplomatic relations between the United States and Georgia, and that partnership has remained so strong throughout the years, in part because of the kinds of bonds and natural friendship that I think you see when through the Peace Corps program, perhaps better than anything else we do here. It reflects our shared values, including a love of freedom and independence, a deep respect for human rights, recognition that diversity and tolerance are truly the strength of a democracy. For over 30 years, the American people have stood in solidarity with the people of Georgia to support you on your path to reviving this nation, building a vibrant and modern economy, improving education and healthcare, and developing a robust civil society. And there is perhaps no clearer example of Americans standing in solidarity with the people of Georgia than the one provided by Peace Corps volunteers. In 2001, one of my predecessors as U.S. Ambassador to Georgia, Kenneth Yalowitz, had the distinct honor of overseeing the signing of the first country agreement between Peace Corps and the government of Georgia. And since then, over 900 volunteers have lived in Georgian communities with Georgian families. They've taught English alongside Georgian teachers in Georgian schools. They've worked with founders, boards, and staff of Georgian organizations to help them better serve their beneficiaries. They've mentored, coached, laughed, danced, and celebrated with young Georgians, helping them make life decisions and become leaders in their communities. To me, Peace Corps and Peace Corps volunteers represent diplomacy at a person-to-person level. It's a diplomacy that requires living with and learning alongside the people you serve, so you come to better understand each other's culture, history, dreams. I can't think of better ambassadors for the United States than our Peace Corps volunteers.
Ჩვენთვის კორპუსის მოხალისეთა საქმიანობა ეს არის დიპლომატია პირისპირ ადამიანთა შორის, ეს არის დიპლომატიის სახე, რომელიც მოიცავს ცხოვრებას ერთად, სწავლას, მხალხთან ერთად, რომელსაც ემსახურებიდან კიდევ უკეთ გაიგო და მოაგრძელებს კულტურის, ისტორიის, ტრადიციების და ჩვენთვის თქვენ ხართ ყველაზე საუკეთესო ელჩები.
In my time as ambassador here in Georgia, I've traveled throughout this incredible country, seeing the amazing work that the United States and our Georgian partners have done together. I've had the chance to meet a number of the principals and the teachers that have been partners with previous Peace Corps volunteers, and will again with some of you. And I feel very honored to have had that opportunity.
ჩვენი ქვეყნის მრავალი რეგიონი და გრძნობოდი საქმეს, რასაც ამერიკის შეერთებული შტატების სამხედროში აკეთებს და მე მქონდა შესაძლებლობა შევხვედროდი მშვიდობის კორპუსის პარტნიორებს, მასპინძელ ოჯახს, მასწავლებლებს და ძალიან გვიხარიებენ, რასაც მაქვს ეს შესაძლებლობა.
Everywhere I've gone, I've visited Peace Corps partners, families, students, beneficiaries, and they've all come up to me and said, "When are our Peace Corps volunteers coming back? Please, please, we want them back." And I am so glad that the day has finally arrived when we're going to be able to say, "Here they are." Let me add my thanks to Deputy Minister Markovishvili, dear Tamar. Thank you so much for being here today. And sincere thanks to your ministry for your partnership and your sponsorship of the Peace Corps program in Georgia. So much of the magic that comes from Peace Corps work here can be credited to the teachers and the principals who work in partnership with Peace Corps English education volunteers. Your ministry's ongoing support to Peace Corps ensures that these magical collaborative efforts continue to enrich the lives of Georgian students and young people, as well as the lives of our volunteers. As some of you may remember, I arrived in January of 2020 and we were all set to swear in our Peace Corps volunteers in April of 2020 when COVID hit. I'm so happy to say that we didn't cancel those plans. We just delayed them. And finally, today, we're here to swear in this 20th group of Peace Corps volunteers. And I'm so happy that I get to do this before I have to leave Georgia, because this has been something that I have been looking forward to for 3.5 years. Finally, to this fabulous group of volunteers who will soon be pledging the next 2 years of your lives to serving the people of our two great nations while you're here in Georgia, Didi Matlova. Zalion. Your commitment to serve a alongside your Georgian counterparts, to learn from them and to learn with them, to humbly support them in developing new ideas to meet their goals and desires, supports Peace Corps' mission of promoting peace and friendship in such real and important, truly meaningful ways. I wish you, your host families, and your partners all the best in your adventures together over the next 2 years. I am fully confident that you will make the people of America very proud.
Quindi in Pule, madam, it's a kind of working about a misapur of some all the time of Francis Aulot from Edimarkam, the Mahari Tauji of Tafali, the Viscani, and the Vas Kensho, but my business is the Rasubi and the Namus, and the process now do not ask for 20 nieces,
Now the moment we've all been waiting for, may I ask the Peace Corps volunteers to please stand and raise your right hand. And please repeat after me the Peace Corps volunteer pledge of service. I, state your name, promise to serve alongside the people of Georgia. I promise to share my culture with an open heart and an open mind. I promise to foster an understanding of the people of Georgia with creativity, cultural sensitivity, and respect. An understanding of the people of Georgia with creativity, cultural sensitivity, and respect. I will face the challenges of service with patience, humility, and determination. I will embrace the mission of world peace and friendship for as long as I serve and beyond. In the proud tradition of Peace Corps' legacy, and in the spirit of the Peace Corps family, past, present, and future,
I am a Peace Corps volunteer.
It is my honor and pleasure to present to all of you the 23rd Peace Corps volunteer.
Thank you to the people of Kushari and Sarani. Thank you to the Peace Corps staff for the extensive planning and countless hours spent preparing us to take this next step in our journey as volunteers. And thank you to our amazing host families who showed us firsthand the incredible hospitality of the people of Georgia.
Matlop, Ran Sashuleva, Mokvetit, Vergzino, Salikini, Ojachis, everyone. Asade, Matlobaram, Sachis, Degulis Ari, Gagi Kret, Shulia, Bulso.
So 12 weeks ago, we walked off our marshuka with water filters, med kits, suitcases, and a little bit of uncertainty at hand. We were greeted with warm smiles and giggles as we attempted to use our limited Georgian and make our way into our new homes. Most of us had similar experiences our first weekend. There were lots of charades, large gestures, and the occasional use of Google Translate as we did our best to get to know one another those first few days. Thank you to our Georgian language teachers for their guidance and for pushing us to use what we learned each and every day in our language classes. Eventually, our phones and Google Translate came out less and less, and the joy over the weeks that followed as our language skills improved and became more and more evident. I am also proud of my cohort of trainees for all that we have accomplished over the past few months. For many of us, this has been the first time to learn a different language, formally teach in a Georgian classroom, and be away from home for so long. We successfully collaborated on lesson plans with our wonderful counterpart teachers. We organized and facilitated our first of many camps for students. We participated in many aspects of Georgian culture, from eating our heart's desire of lobiani and hachapuri to gaining the trust of the street dogs so that we may pass in peace, to getting a small glimpse into what our next few years will be like in this beautiful country. A few of us even turned a year older. To our new directors, host families, and counterparts, thank you for the patience, generosity, and wisdom you will share with us over the next 2 years. Thank you for inviting us into your communities and schools. We are looking forward to continuing to explore the rich history and culture of Georgia, integrating into our permanent communities, and collaborating with community members on future projects and programs.
Sakavela Mogetona is a question that all of us volunteers have been asked countless times since our arrival in Georgia. Our go-to answer has become Mikhars Sakapelos Lama Zimuneva, Megobili Khalki, Akemiri Satumeli. We chuckle whenever one of us says this, not because it's untrue, but because there's just so much more we wish to convey about our deep appreciation and love for Georgia and the community that has welcomed us with open arms. I remember the morning before departing for Kashori from Tbilisi, when a fellow volunteer and I gazed out at the skyline and shared our excitement, our curiosities, and also our uncertainties about the unknowns that lay ahead. Little did I know that in 10 weeks, I would come to understand the meaning of the Georgian phrase, Stumaviv Tvisa, a guest is sent by God. This sentiment has been palpable since our arrival, from our language teachers, trainers, and staff, who tirelessly prepared us for the Georgian language and culture, to our host families, who have become new family members and dear friends for life. And given the short time frame that we've been in Georgia, we've witnessed a welcoming and open-minded approach to new traditions and learnings. It brings us so much joy to see students embrace the importance of topics like emotional resilience and non-formal education in our trainings, to share with our family members our love of hot sauces that now make their way onto the dinner table each night, and to sing and dance with our host siblings to the 70s pop and soft rock music that we love. As we now move to our sites across Georgia, we can't help but express our gratitude to those who have made and will make our time in Georgia so special. Zali and Didi Madlova to the Bazari and Marketi ladies who patiently taught us to count our coins and now smile as we try on our own. To our neighbors and devias who offer help in times of need. And to our new family members who look out for us as we fumble our way through our new communities. The small acts of community members noticing and including us in their lives has meant the world to us and does not go unnoticed. My fellow IOD volunteers and I now embrace the uncertainties ahead in the next chapter of our Peace Corps journey with the lessons of generosity, openness, and enthusiasm exemplified by our host families, fellow neighbors, and Peace Corps staff. Our experiences in Georgia have ignited within us our commitment towards building a more understanding, a more compassionate, and more connected world in our civil society organizations and with our communities. As we continue to learn and grow alongside our Georgian counterparts, we hope to one day, in Kartula, articulate the truly deep gratitude and love we hold in our hearts for Sakakawa. Madlaba.
Now I will ask our new volunteers to take your seats in the auditorium and we'll welcome the Tbilisi State University Dance Group to the stage.
Ahlaki trends mohalisex, called Gadarines on Auditoriashi, Trenkin Yasanovi, Tbilisi Sahalpiko University, and to our dance. Thank you.
Thank you.